Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. We'll begin the service shortly, but if you could move forward in your chairs so that if any latecomers can come in the back, that'd be appreciated. We'll start shortly. Thank you.
Good morning and welcome everyone present and everyone who's online as we begin our service this morning in honouring and celebrating the life of a much-loved Nana Ramsamy. On behalf of Nana's family, thank you all for your prayers, love and support at this time of family loss. Let us please stand as the pallbearers enter the auditorium.
I don't wanna go alone. Now, angel, won't you come by me? Angel, hear my plea. Take my hand, lift me up so that I can fly with thee, so that I can fly with thee. And I'm waiting on an angel, and I know it won't be long to find myself a resting place in my angel's arms, my angel's arms. So speak kind to a stranger, 'cause you'll never know. It just might be an angel knocking at your door, knocking at your door. And I'm waiting on an angel, and I know it won't be long to find myself a resting place in my angel's arms, oh, in my angel's arms. Hope you come see me soon, 'cause I don't wanna go alone. I don't wanna go alone. Don't wanna go. I don't wanna go alone.
Let us just please open in prayer. Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we come here today and we welcome you, Holy Spirit, for your love and your comfort to the family of dear Nana Ramsamy, as we come here and celebrate the life of a very special lady, Nana Ramsamy, a life that was touched and changed by the power of your love, a life that not only knows you, but has touched many other lives as well. We thank you, Lord Jesus, that this is a faithful saying, for if we die with him, we shall also live with him. We thank you, as Nana passed away, that she was in Jesus Christ, knew Jesus as a personal Lord and Saviour. And so, looking at the Word of God, we thank you. Absent from the body is to be present with you. We thank you in Jesus' wonderful name. Amen. God bless you. Please be seated. Nana's last years, her local church was the Slade Point Christian Life Centre, and that's where she attended. And it's a great privilege this morning to invite to the podium her pastor, Pastor Manasseh, as he comes this morning and shares the scripture.
Thank you. Nana was not only a member of our church, she was a mother to the church and also our auntie and our Nana. And she was a faithful woman of God. And she always and good an example to the church, and she was a faithful woman of God. I'll read her favorite scripture in Joel chapter 2, verse 28 to 32, and also Acts chapter 2, verses 16, which is the same thing. The Bible says, this is her faithful scripture. And it shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. And your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams. Your young men shall see visions. And also upon the servants and upon the handmaids, in those days will I pour out my spirit, and I will shew wonders in heavens and in earth, blood and fire and pillars of smoke. The sun shall turn into darkness and the moon into blood before the great and terrible day of the Lord come. And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be delivered, for in Mount Zion and in Jerusalem shall be deliverance, as the Lord hath said, and in the remnant whom the Lord shall call. Amen.
It's a privilege at this time also to welcome the Mayor of Mackay, the Mayor Greg Williamson, as he comes to pay tribute to Nana as well.
Good morning. What a wonderful send-off. It's great to see the extended family the representatives of our community, Nana's sister Emily and her family from Torres, and also niece Dolly from Torres, and to all of the streamed viewers. It's my humble honour to be able to deliver a civic message today for Nana's funeral. Death is a part of life, they tell us. And sad as they are, so are funerals. It's the chance that we get to celebrate the life of an incredible person. And generally, the sad part about funerals is that the person whose life we are celebrating doesn't hear it. But I think Nana has heard what we think of her and of her contribution to our lives and our community. At most of her birthday celebrations in recent years, especially her 100th. The amazing twists of fate that create the journey for one's time on earth is no more evident than in the incredible story of Nana and Sammy's life. We can only imagine the upheaval for a young woman, Aliyah Barber, forced to abandon her home and lifestyle on Thursday Island because of the impending Japanese invasion in 1942. We probably can't imagine what she and 200 other Thursday Islanders were forced to endure over 12 months at the Cherbourg Aboriginal Mission. Tom Blake's book on Cherbourg is titled Dumping Ground. So that paints a picture of what her life would have been like at that stage. Thankfully, for Nana and for this huge, loving family and for our community, she found her way to Mackay and fell in love with one Edward Royster and Sammy. Ram Chandra is often described as a special breed of man, one of those people who devoted their life to the betterment of others. And that is certainly true, but he did it with a wonderful woman by his side. There's no doubt that Nana has been the defender of the values that hold this wonderful family together. The sense of identity, the positive and special way that celebrates and connects, the quiet demonstration of faith, family, and fishing. Her serenity, her humility, and her gracious, straightforward approach to life are the lasting impressions that I have of Nana Ramsamy. She was probably the author of the saying, follow your own road to happiness, staying true to yourself and to the people you love. The richness of the human experience comes to us from the people we encounter on our individual journey through life. The bricks and mortar of our physical surroundings ultimately don't matter. It's the people who create the memories. People like Nana Ramsamy, who devote their journey to improving the lives of others, selflessly, quietly, and expecting nothing more than to leave the world a better place. This wonderful family has lost a much-loved, irreplaceable queen. Our community has lost one of our most outstanding citizens.
Well, the next two men that I invite to the platform right now, I've known them, and of course Nana did when as well. They were just little babies, and so if Bodine and Namaka could please come. Now both these men coming, they're both pastors. First one here, Pastor Bodine Gilbank. He's a senior minister now. Just took over from his father, Pastor John and Rose Gilbank, and then Namaka, he's also a pastor with Pastor Manasseh at Slade Point Christian Life Centre. They're going to sing a few songs this morning. Well, they're going to sing one item now and one a little bit later. But we need to know that these songs and this song here and the one we'll hear later, absolute one of Nana's favourites. Some of the words here I'm sure will take many people back. There are people here today, I've been the last week just preparing for this celebration today for Nana, that I've spoken to some people that, like grandchildren of Nana, that remember these songs. We're in the same church, no longer there now, but many people in this place that still remember the old picture theatre, the Regal Theatre, burnt down now, but there was a great move of God there in the 80s. And one of those songs in that great move of God was a song that Bodine and Namaka ago sing right now.
Growing up, I remember these songs being sung, and Mama Barola and Nana Ram Semi and Ani Nami all singing, and just to hear the island harmonies.
Thank you.
precious gold, my Lord Jesus, just the mention of your name. Thank you, Jesus.
I'm sure that song, just the words, just the presence of God on it, would touch your heart. Thanks so much, Bowen, Namaka. We'll hear from them just a little later. You can see a song like that, no wonder Nana loved it so much and one of her favourites. Hope you really enjoyed it. Right now, it's a time for the eulogy, and I'm just going to ask that's going to be presented, delivered by the grandchildren, Lawrence, Annette, Jason, and Leah. So if I could ask them, please, to come to the platform. The eulogy delivered by the grandchildren.
Today, we honour the life of Nolia Ramsamy, a great matriarch and much-loved member of the Mackay community, who passed away peacefully on Monday, the 22nd of March, at the age of 103 years and 6 months. Nolia, affectionately known as Nana Ramsamy, was adored by her family, friends, and a wider community, as we can see here today. Nolia Ramsamy was born in Port Lou on Prince of Wales Island in the Torres Straits on October 6, 1917. She was the fourth child of 13 children born to father Said Bin Baba and mother Marion Moy. As a young woman, Nana enjoyed life in the Torres Strait Islands, going fishing and hunting with her brothers and going to the picture show with her sisters. Her younger life was full of fun and mischief, though she always was working hard to support the growing family, cleaning and working with her father, cutting firewood at the Pearl Farms. Her love of fishing was born from endless fishing trips accompanying her father when she was a young girl. In 1941, Japan declared war, and Nana and her family and the majority of the civilian population of Thursday Island were evacuated to the mainland in 1942. The journey took them by ship and barge from Thursday Island to Townsville, then by truck to the Cherbourg Mission. Whilst in Cherbourg, the family lived on rations issued by the government, and Nana and her sisters would walk 7 kilometres to Mergen to get supplies to put food on the table. She made friends with the local Aboriginal community there, and many lifelong friendships were formed. The family left Cherbourg in 1943, settling in North Mackay. To support her family, Nana worked several jobs as a cleaner, laundry hand, and as a ticket seller at the local show. Whilst working at the show, she met a handsome showman of Indian descent from Lawrence in New South Wales, Edward Royce Ramsamy, later famously known as Ram Chandra, the Taipan Man. Nana and Pop were married in Mackay in 1944. The newlyweds soon moved to Thornbury Street before moving to Wren Street, Slade Point, where they raised their family, Rhonda, Nami, Selma, Edward Jr., Albert, John, Sissy, Annette, Brian, Lawrence, and Mari.
Over the years, the Wren Street home hosted many family and Christmas gatherings. Christmas Day lunch was an event attended not only by immediate family, but anyone who wanted to share a meal, the more the merrier. This was always followed by a game of rounders across the road at Cathy Freeman Oval. Nana was always a willing participant. Wren Street was also home to a menagerie of animals, which included chickens, goats, sheep, aviaries of birds and cockatoos, ponds of fish, dogs and a cow at one point. Together with Pop's snake, it was a sight to behold. Whilst Pop travelled the countryside educating the public about taipans and snake bites, first aid, Nana, with the support of the older children, took care of their large family. Although at times life was hard, Nana was always a hard worker, had strong faith, and family always came first. She opened her home to not only her extended family, but also to the friends of her children and anyone in need. Following family tradition, Nana would ensure every potential in-law was taken to collect uckles, oysters and pennywinkles. This became a rite of passage into the family. Many family members here today would have a tale to tell of their experiences. Let's be honest, I think we all have a fishing story about Nana and her most favourite size of fish to pan fry, crispy and brown, especially whiting. She would try all types of tactics to keep these catches, and should you return any to the water, you would not be in her good books. As a Torres Strait Islander, living off the ocean and mangroves, hunting and fishing were always considered important to Nana. This was both a source of food for the family and also a celebration of culture. Family gatherings always provided a huge feast and plenty of laughter. Family holidays in the early years were a loaded boat trip to Newry Island, which involved many transfers back and forth, ferrying kids and food. Recently, Nana was able to revisit Newry Island and reminisce about these happy times. To assist her in getting to shore, she was carried up the beach very regularly like a queen.
Can you imagine Nana being carried up the beach? She would have been laughing. Don't jock me. What's all the fuss about? She would have been playing it up big time. Nana touched many people in her own special way, proper island style. Everyone gathered here today would appreciate Nana's great sense of fun and adventure. Nana immersed herself in family. In her younger years, she involved herself with the activities of her children, and in later years, this involvement extended to her children's families. Nana enjoyed camping and fishing trips and would outfish anyone who took up the challenge. True too. If a family member asked her to go out on an outing coming up, she would always keep her options open, just in case a better offer presented itself. Especially if it involved fishing. She also attended many football matches where she would be the loudest barracker from the sidelines. During State of Origin, Pop would always support the Maroons, and Nana, just to stir the pot, would cheer on the Blues. To keep Pop on his toes, this affectionate rivalry would continue with all NRL games and pretty much everything else in the household, including cricket matches with the Indians, the West Indians, Pakistanians, and the Australians. Nana always gave that cheeky smile and her laugh. A shopping trip to town with Nana would take twice as long as then planned, as she would meet so many people who would come up to her to say hello and have a chat. Before you even reached the shops, there would be many pit stops along the way, checking if this one or that one would want to join the trip to the shopping centre. Anyone that wanted to tag along, she'd try and fill the car up. Nana was very active. She was always willing to travel, either with family or to see family. Some of her travel destinations included Singapore, Cairns, Darwin, Pomperol, up in Cape York, Melbourne, Newcastle, Canberra and Western Australia. And Nana would often return home to Thursday Island, where there were always fun times. with tears of laughter flowing whenever she got together with her sisters and brothers, sharing stories of their youth. I'm sure there would have been plenty of belly laughs along that road. Nana was also famous for her wording, one round. She'd always want to jump in the car and go for a cruise. Those one rounds were always unlimited kilometres. You had to have a full tank of fuel. No matter how long that trip would take, Nana would be there. She used to also travel up and down that Bruce Highway, which should have been known as Nana's Highway. She was up and down that Saline Latrine, heading up the east coast of Cairns. Just very recently, Nana accompanied family to Thursday Island, where there was many photos taken, reflected on the wonderful time she was having catching up with family, with everyone that was still there. In 1992, Nana was fortunate enough to see the majority of her family congregate for the Bin Barber reunion held at her son's property at Mount Blackwood over the Easter long weekend. This number was estimated to be greater than 500 at the time. These days were filled with plenty of dancing, singing, and laughter.
Organising one of Nana's milestones required a lot of planning and manpower. Her 90th birthday was one of these occasions, which was held at Slade Point Community Hall. Nana and her sisters and nieces were at the Wren Street house cooking one of her favourite dishes, or so we thought. When a family went to check on how they were going, they discovered that there was no cooking going on, but instead they were in full swing practising their line dancing number that they were going to perform that night, which was a huge hit. Nolly and Ram celebrated their 50th wedding anniversary at the North Mackay Bowls Club. But unfortunately, only a few years later, in 1998, Nan lost her beloved Ram. During declining health in recent years, Nana resided with family members, but yearned to return to her beloved Red Street home, a home where she was surrounded by her loving memories of Pop and her family. Nana did not let age defy her and loved being outdoors, having her 103rd birthday celebrations at Shoal Point Park at the end of last year. During her lifetime, Nana has seen 4 British monarchs, 26 prime ministers, and the Australian population has grown from 5 million to 26 million. Nana received her letter from the Queen on her 100th birthday, which she displayed proudly. Nana Ramsamy was a loving wife of 54 years and a mother of 12 children, 9 surviving. 42 grandchildren, 39 surviving. 104 great-grandchildren, 99 surviving. 63 great-great-grandchildren, and 6 great-great-grandchildren. If you don't believe those numbers, just look in the hall tonight. We are honoured to have so many of Nana's beloved family and friends come out and celebrate her life with us today. Nana has enriched our lives, and with her love of family, her love of culture, and her mischievous spirit, many here will have their own stories to tell of a happy time spent with this amazing, remarkable woman. What a legacy, what a life. What a Nan, what a mother, what a auntie. Nana, we are all so fortunate to have known and loved you. We will all miss you greatly. We know you are with us today and are smiling at the beautiful memories we've shared. We will continue to celebrate your life in all that we do, in all that we are, and we will keep you alive in our hearts. To live in the hearts of those you leave behind is to live forever. Love you, Nan.
Just ask everyone right now, just if you, we look to the screens, I'm sure we're going to be blessed to the max just with a photographic reflection of Nana Ram Sammy as we look to the screens right now. What an absolutely beautiful presentation. And I'd just like to give another great hand clap just to for Nana's life as well, just to celebrate her. And whoever, and I know it's the whole family, you put this day together, but whoever just put that presentation together, whoever you are, we just want to thank you. So let's give them a big clap too. That's just wonderful. Celebrating Nana's life. Well, I've just got a little moment here just to share a message. I first met Nana back in 1980, September 1980, and I would have said at the start of the service that in the old Regal Picture Theatre in North Mackay, it's no longer there now. It burnt down, but at that time there was a tremendous move of the Holy Spirit in our city, and God is still moving. Don't forget about that. But there was a time that Nana, no wonder her scripture that she asked to share, the family asked to share today, was from the book of Joel, chapter 2, verse 28, talking about in the last day, says God, I'll pour out my spirit upon all flesh. And of course, then in Acts chapter 2, that's on the day of Pentecost, the great outpouring, that was the fulfillment of the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. And so here's Nana, was caught up in a move and experienced that herself. She was born again, spirit-filled lady, loved Jesus, told many. I myself, and many of the Ransomi family, the boys especially, some of the girls, they knew me back in 1980. They knew me as a bit of a wild guy, quite wild. I mean, I was only just talking to them the other day, but I mean, we worked hard and played hard. And we used to go to the Kooyong and, well, anyway, I was in a life. Lauren's still laughing about it. But I was in a lifestyle that was far from God. If I'd continued in that lifestyle, my marriage wouldn't have lasted, that's for sure. It was only because I had a wife that really believed in me, stuck with me. But something happened back then, and I couldn't even really work it out myself so much. There was a great change. It was just like I felt compelled that I had to. I was dissatisfied with the lifestyle of just drinking and, you know, fighting and all that. You know, it's just, anyway, I give all honor to God for what he did. And so that's when I met Nana back there. And so that's something like 40 years now. And in my, because then I became a pastor as well, but a lot of my ministry has been like travelling overseas. I've done a lot of mission works overseas. And something Nana was always very interested. And I'd get the message, oh, Nana wants to see you. She's asking when your next trip is, where you've just come back from. So Karen and I would often go and visit Nana, and she'd look at the videos on my phone of pictures and, well, more video clips, and she loved it. And so she prayed me. So I really honour Nana for that. And to the very end, just be able to go and see her and know someone's praying for you. And of course, the whole thing is she's prayed for so many of you in this place. And I, on behalf of Nana, I want to encourage everyone here, especially all, well, everybody, but all your grandchildren that went, that Nana took to that old picture theatre back in the 80s. You would have heard the songs that Bodine and Namaka sang. You would have felt the love of God. You would have felt the Holy Spirit touch you. And you may have lost your way. When God encountered my life and changed me, when I talked about in 1980, I was at a time in my life, I'd lost my way. Many people lose their way. Many people get lost. Just like getting a flat tire on the side of the road, you're hopeless really until that's repaired. I was hopeless until I let God come and repair my life. And so here's this scripture that she loved, the great outpouring of the Holy Spirit. And so the Apostle Peter, he preaches on the day of Pentecost. And of course he preaches the death, the burial, the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ, what the power of the gospel is. And then it says their hearts were overcome and they said, what must we do? And it was something that I did. I said, what must I do? And I really dissatisfied my life. It's called repentance. If you're dissatisfied, maybe it's a time to say, Jesus, help me. I need your help. And so I asked the other day, I thought to myself, 103. Well, I think 103 and a half, isn't she? I thought to myself, boy, that's a long time. I wonder why. And this is just the thought I got. I wonder if there was one more prayer she had to pray. I wonder if there was one more person, one more grandchild, somebody that she just had to say, hey, you need Jesus. Why don't you give your life to Jesus? I'm just going to ask right now for Bodine and pastor at C3 Church in Mackay, his great friend Namaka, and he's also a pastor with Pastor Manasseh at Slate Point Christian Life Centre. They're going to sing another song right now. And it's called Hold My Hand. You probably heard, some of you would have heard this song before. Tremendous song. I want to warn you up front. It's a song, if you listen to these words, it's very convicting sort of song. It's a song that requires a decision. It's a song that will help you make a decision. It's a song that in your heart you'll feel like, hey, I need to give my life to Jesus. Hold my hand. Anyway, the words speak for themselves. Just before they play, I remember it was 1990. I was with Nana and some friends. We're on Lambert's Beach Lookout. And we'd had a prayer meeting up there. We'd just been praying this particular day. And so Nana was there, and Nana had this prophetic word. She felt like God had given her this word, and like a vision. And this is what it was. She said, I see like a tidal wave. She called it tidal wave. We might call it a tsunami, but it's like a tsunami or a tidal wave that was coming in off the ocean, over the sea, from the east, from the ocean, coming right up over Slade Point, flowing into our city with a mighty move of the Holy Spirit. I believe that when she said that. I still believe that. And I believe God wants to do it. And He wants to do it. I felt these words today. He wants to do it through young men and women like this age here, this generation that's coming through. He wants to do it through many of you that are relatives, grandchildren, family of Nana. The prayer that she prayed for you the words she's spoken over you. And I encourage as we listen to this song that you might return to the God, the Jesus of your childhood, the God that someone told you about, the God you experienced as a little girl or a little boy back in the 80s when Nana took you, or whatever, even to this last days of Nana as she spoke to you. Enjoy this song. Open up your heart. Let Jesus love you so much.
Into my heart.
just as they sing this song, just hold my hand just one more time. Don't let this opportunity pass you by. Don't let the prayers of Nana just fade away. If God's touching you in your heart, I really encourage you, even this day or very, very soon, see Bodine or Namaka. Nana had many relatives, friends who are, they know Jesus Christ as their Lord and Saviour. I encourage you to see them and say, hey, what's next? Pursue, carry on. Don't just stay in the lifestyle. Don't let Nana's prayers just pass you by. Just ask now for the pallbearers to take their positions.
Into my heart, come, Lord Jesus, be my guide. Show me the way, for I'm just a man with a great need for love. Here I come.
I just like to let everyone know, please, that just the immediate family will be following the hearse, because it'd be just a traffic jam if everyone tries to. So we're just asking, the family's asking everyone, just please, just find your own way to Mount Bassett Cemetery. I'm not sure of the time right now, but it's, the time was to be slotted into 11 o'clock or when everyone's there. Thank you.
For the place where I belong.
'cause you flow away so far away.
I took your breath.